What would be the scariest message humanity could receive from outer space? Multiply 5 missed calls. Some kind of for real doomsday countdown. Give us a little time to think about how we are screwed, and there's nothing we can do about it. There is something comforting to me that we would go down together as a species. In the end, we would all be the same. And no amount of money or success could change it. Everything leading up to that moment had meant everything. And then nothing at the same time. Ugh, great, so we are all gonna be lumped in with pedophiles and people that put the mother-in-law kin before the tea bag and water. Absolute disgusting psychopaths. Pedophiles too. Dawn of the first day, multiply 72 hours remain, and moon starts to get closer to Earth. Don't worry, we can send the small possibly dwarf kid to gather masks, so he can wake up the giants from their slumber, so they can stop the moon. Be quiet. I would really prefer if you would be quiet. Just a distress signal on permanent repeat. Then another one a few years later. Then another one. Then another 10. Then thousands. Then they all just stop. There's a short story about this. Humanity start getting signals from everywhere, and when deciphering them, it turns out they are basically goodbyes from every other species as the universe ends. Yep, that sounds right up my alley. Do you remember the name of the author? Pretty sure it was Stephen Baxter. Either one of his short story collection or one of them in the year's best sci-fi collections by Gardner Dozois. If you love hard sci-fi, the older Baxter novels are amazing. His Never Stuff Is Meh. Last Contact, I believe, is the name of it. New planet, who dis? A massive unsolicited planet pick in the sky. I sent you my moon, PLS respond. Message 5164. Citizens of Earth. We have attempted several times to contact your species regarding self-protection from the imminent solar flare that will occur at the beginning of year 2021. We hope you received the detailed instructions on how to build your shelters. This transmission is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. Be quiet, or it will hear you. It's basically the Dark Forest theory. It says that every colonization in the universe is a hunter, stalking its prey and lurking in the jungle, which is universe, not giving away its presence like a ghost. There's a reason the animals in the jungle don't yell all day. They don't know what could get them. They just know they shouldn't give away their position to stay safe. A monkey doesn't yell at a tiger, for example. Meanwhile, we are out here just screaming inside the void. The question is, who or what is the tiger? Stop transmitting. They will hear you. Oh duck. That's actually freaky. Go read the Three Body Problem trilogy. I've just finished the Salvation trilogy by Peter F. A mother-in-law, and well worth a read if you like sci-fi. Link. Just a countdown timer with no other context. The countdown starts at 10 and unexpectedly stops at 5. People start to panic and get confused and worried. But as years go by and nothing relevant happened, most of them think it was a huge case of mass hysteria. People shrug it off, and most start to forget about it. But 5 years later, and completely out of nowhere, boom, multiply 4, 3, 2, and it stops again. Oh no. Calm down, Satan. Buy 3 pigs, label them 12, and 4 and grease them up. Then release them wherever you want to cause mayhem. Screams, and an abrupt stop. We are sorry, we weren't able to stop them. OIUGITZ. It's time to crump those humans, or am I not the biggest baddest warbus in this sector? The threat they weren't able to stop. Unironically, an orc infestation would be terrifying for our current level of technology. We'd be royally ducked if orcs invaded us. Is there anything in WH40K that wouldn't immediately curb stomp the planet? Heck. Dad orcs are probably the best hope for us to get invaded, because they would only kill us. Orcs also enslave humans as well. So technically tyrannids would be the best hope, because all they do is truly kill. Orcs do much worse. Earthlings. Can we have our ball back, please? No can do. It kinda turned into our moon and now we need it to support life. Hate it when something you like turns into the moon. Edit, wow. Thank you all. My first award. Edit 2, I was made aware that it is generally frowned upon to express one's thanks to the people giving out awards. If that is the case, I take mine back then. That's rough, buddy. We've been trying to reach you about your car's extended warranty. Cars Planets. Shit, that's a lot funnier. Hurry in for your planet's Toyota-thon. Children laughing. But it's definitely 100% absolutely guaranteed to be coming from near the center of the galaxy. Oh god. The call was coming from inside the galaxy. Anything that we could understand would be pretty scary. Like they just send a "Hey, we are aliens, nice to meet you" message. But if it happens to be in one of our languages, that means they've been studying us or something like that. I dunno. I think I'd be scared and excited simultaneously. Also, it's not like we wouldn't study their language if we got messages. So it's not that creepy. Doesn't have to be malicious. Just "Hey, what the heck are they saying?" Followed by a lot of linguistic studying until they figure out how to talk back. Seems friendly. I agree. Attempting to establish communications is the best case scenario out of aliens. I for one always prefer when strangers talk to me instead of enslaving everyone while stripping the planet of all natural resources. That's just me though. Deploy your planetary shield. Incoming gamma ray burst in 48 hours. I don't like this one. What do you mean? We are all getting superpowers. Total win. My hero name will be Captain Irradiated Corpse. With the superpower of not rotting on account of decomposers like fungi and bacteria also being dead. Run. Bass drops. Doom Eternal soundtrack plays faster and faster. In a few moments, we will broadcast the most viewed video on a website you call YouTube. It is known as Baby Shark. We hope this will improve our relations with the Earth. After the broadcast, your space agencies have sent us countless messages. And now we will play a random song on shuffle and try to fix this situation. Never gonna give you up starts. Edit, we got onto YouTube. Boys and girls, I link watch the robotic voice read my reply last night. Link. You are the last. Be better than us. No proceeds to stumble into a nuclear war over a misunderstanding. Honestly, I'd prefer misunderstanding over hatred. If you are reading this message, it is too late. That message came to us from Toronto already. Are the Egyptians still in charge? Experiment unsuccessful. Prepare for termination and reset. Someone just needs to talk the mice into giving us another go. You were once my greatest achievement. Now, you are my greatest failure. I cannot protect you any longer. Forgive me. Edit, wow. Thank you so much for the likes and the awards. I've never gotten an award before. What a way to start the new year. For the people asking where the quote came from, I just made it up on my lunch break yesterday while browsing Reddit. It's so vague though. It sounds like something out of a movie. I'm really glad you guys all like it. Happy New Year. Let's hope this doesn't come to pass. Videos of Earth's previous mass extinction events, of which most mainstream scientists conclude there have been at least 5 or images explaining the disappearances of certain peoples. The video is lengthy, detailed, in vivid color, and yet has no audio. So, imagine seeing actual dinosaurs dying on video from all sorts of camera angles, and no matter how you try to rationalize it, you know it's real footage. Even though you've obviously never seen Earth like this. Imagine seeing previous hominid species like Australopithecus or whatnot dying, like you see on "I'll Make My Coffin." What if NASA received footage of the Egyptians or Mayans or Incans or any other lost civilizations being disappeared? The entire time I would be freaking TF out. Asking myself who the heck recorded this. Is Earth just a huge galactic snuff father-in-law set? Are we next? Was this a warning? Too long didn't read silent. High definition video footage of all of Earth's previous life forms dying over the course of Earth's existence. We are in a go. 73 Earth orbits ago you killed our emissary. Prepare to die. Then the spaceship lands and is promptly eaten whole by a passing dog. Just another miscalculation of scale. They are hungry, they are coming. They are here. Your free trial of Earth has ended. Please select a premium planet payment plan from the options below. Warning, your species has been targeted for containment. Your planet is a prison and you are violating the terms of your imprisonment. Any further attempt to explore space will be punished. You have 30 days to comply. Game over. Continue. And then a tense countdown starts, but we won't know where to insert the coin. You are alone. That's like the alien equivalent of "Are you asleep?" Yes. We impose order on the chaos of organic evolution. You exist because we allow it, and you will end because we demand it. Here's an explanation of your planetary inhabitant association fees and benefits. We are Borg. You will be as a mother-in-law-lated. Resistance is futile. You have 24 hours. Help, you are now the universe's only hope. It's Friday. Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. You are not alone. But you'll soon wish you were. Because we are going to be the most annoying methodicking aliens you ever did see. Yowza same. Misa. Stay put, or you will suffer the same fate as you. People of Earth, your attention please. This is Prestetnik Vogonjeltz of the Galactic Hyperspace Planning Council. As you will no doubt be aware, the plans for development of the outlying regions of the galaxy require the building of a hyperspatial express route through your star system. And regrettably, your planet is one of those scheduled for demolition. The process will take slightly less than 2 of your Earth minutes. Thank you. There's no point in acting surprised about it. All the planning charts and demolition orders have been on display at your local planning department in Alpha Centauri for 50 of your Earth years. So you've had plenty of time to lodge any formal complaint, and it's far too late to start making a fuss about it now. What do you mean you've never been to Alpha Centauri? Oh. For heaven's sake. Mankind. It's only 4 light years away, you know. I'm sorry. But if you can't be bothered to take an interest in local affairs, that's your own lookout. Energize the demolition beams. In the beginning, the universe was created. This has made a lot of people very angry and been widely regarded as a bad move. The following is a message composed via consensus of the O5 Council. For those who are not currently aware of our existence, we represent the organization known as the SCP Foundation. Our previous mission centered around the containment and study of anomalous objects, entities and other assorted phenomena. This mission was the focus of our organization for more than 100 years. Due to circumstances outside of our control, this directive has now changed. Our new mission will be the extermination of the human race. There will be no further communication. The one we can be sure was directed to us by a sentient being, but none is able to decode, no matter how hard they try. Humanity's future has been secured through the wormhole. Thank you for your sacrifice. We are watching, and waiting, commiserating. Show me what you got. We see you. Bees say that to wasps, before they burn them alive with their own vibrations. Scary shit, alien bees. Alien 1, you those guys back there absolutely ducked us. Alien 2, yeah man, I hope they didn't follow us. Don't go to Venus. Misa Jar Jar Binks. But Hosarai Yowza. We tried. Absolute. Deafening silence for the next 500 plus years. Signifying that we are indeed alone in this vast galaxy. Could just mean that we get to be the precursor race that seeds the galaxy, and other races mother-in-lawlions of years from now will stumble upon our ruins. Okay. They failed. Turn off the simulation. We really ducked things up in space. Can we stay at your place for a while? A recall from the abyss. Honestly, I would sort of love that. Some other beings out there just trying to speak to us in a way they think we enjoy. I guess there could be the fear they have been studying or watching us. But that seems pretty normal for anything coming up on something they don't know. Just some beings going, well, we know they keep doing this thing all the time. They're like I, we do this thing too. Hello. I'll never give you up. Yes. Those beings should like that. Now we are friendly. We know all of your search histories. Don't blink. Don't turn your back. Don't look away. And don't blink. It's still coming. No static. Time's up. Primitive life form detected. Consume and move on to primary objective. Local population possesses no danger. Be sure to drink your Ovaltine. Help us. We've all got the shits up here. Bye. People will start wondering if we already received a visit, if aliens were living with us, and if there are, were any half-human half-alien, or if this is their message to say we are killing you all in some way, like with a Death Star's super laser or some lethal virus. We received your message, accompanied with a golden plate we send into space like ages ago. It's not scary because of what it says, but what they don't say. No intent, no purpose. Everyone will ducking panic trying to figure out what they're gonna do, waiting for them to maybe never arrive. Fear of the unknown is the greatest of all fears and the root of most.